Observe Wickenburg Canyon High. State funded.
Oh my God, ew!
There are some very dark things going on there in the name of so-called science. In fact, our recent intel tells us they are harvesting souls. That's right. Millions of little souls called stem cells. Now, team, stem cells are harvested from a pregnant woman's belly button near that smelly, disgusting hole thing they have down there.
Is that called a vagina?
Yuck! Don't even say it! I believe the male member is much more elegant and surprising. Why, one time, I was playing a game of sword fights with my
Sir! About saving the world?
Yes! Yes, we have to stop them! You see, they want to build a mutant army and give people extra arms and legs so they can win at football and fondle your wives and daughters at the same time!
Really?
Really! Hey, where's Dirk?
Hey, team! Kung Fu Rainbow Laser Force! Yeah!
Dirk?
Oh, yeah. Sorry I'm tardy. I'm just so full of school spirit, you know? Parvenu Hills rules! Woo!
That's okay, Dirk. You're good at sports, so we turn a collective blind eye to your remedial level reading skills.
I can't read.
I know you can't. Lack of basic manners, mistreatment of classmates, and the fact that you're 25 years old and have yet to come close to graduating.
Oh, thank you, Hillary. Mr. Hitzman.
Yes. I was just telling the team about some of the terrible stuff that's been going on at Wickenburg.
Wickenburg can suck my nutsack, them boners!
Really? Can they? I mean, that won't be necessary, Dirk. Unless it would save America.
Now that would be controversial.
Check out the new vehicle on the podium. You can win it with just a spin on the lucky wheel.
Last ride before
I'm not
she's
lucky.
A prize! Get her while she's hot!
Taylor, stop it! It's so irritating!
Welcome. Your chips.
Ready for some real excitement? Bet on the ponies at the Inside Track, the premier horse racing lounge at the Diamond Casino and Resort.
More chips.
Back third.
third. It's the fourth. They're halfway home. Horse six is now second. First place for the two horse. Coming down to the finish. Hot and Mother for the win.
Woohoo! Money!
Doesn't it? Okay. Okay. Cancel check. Let's go. Okay.
Coming to the wire.
Coming to the wire.
A delicious win for Salt and Sauce.
Sup?
And the trophy goes to the four. The runner up is the two. And for the three, it's third. 5 minutes till post time.
Later.
deposited the money. Hello. Why is my car not put away? I put it away the last time I played. Let's go to the music locker. Hello. There we go. Hmm. Holy slow, Batman.
Plug it. Lucky escape. Yeah, the funny thing is, the dream guy in her head wouldn't even step over and take a leap.
Ready to fill that void in your soul for a moment? Shop for the hottest new fashions at the casino store.
Oh, ruined my joyride. Just as I was about to do something cool. People shooting up outside the casino again. I was gonna say, you're gonna run him down, right?
Fuck! We lost!
Did they?
You're dead!
I will eat you!
Chip. Well, that was unfortunate.
Thank you.
Well, that was rude. Well, that was unfortunate.
Sir, leave the area now. This is for authorized personnel only. I'm not going to say this again! Leave now! Go, 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 go.
Look at all those blood stains on the front of the car. Really? Oh my God. think I've left a vehicle in here. Yeah, I didn't think so.
Hey, it's...
God, these people drive slow. Oh shit, that wouldn't have been good. Mm-hmm.
I don't see him!
You shit!
Nowhere near a cop, shouldn't. Shouldn't my wanted level be dissipating by now? No cop anywhere near me. Seriously. Why hasn't my wanted level gone down? Well. We know one way to get our wanted level down is to just go into the casino. No cops, even anywhere around here. Okay, this is weird. Why do I still have a wanted level even?
Track features the top fillies and mares racing for glory. Come enjoy the thrill of horse racing. New races every few minutes.
Turn around. I'm so confused because no cops seem to be looking for me.
Hey.
Okay. Now I've got a 3-star weight. Now people seem interested in me. I hear cops coming now. There we go.
That's right. Who needs a government bailout?
face the big boys and the bold facts of the world and the way it works? Well, let's go stand in the middle of a park for literally no reason. I see something in you, Dylan. You seem naive and in need of a father figure because yours probably died or is gay. But you're also hungry and greedy and vindictive, which I
okay.
Just sheep.
I am a sheep. Bah. I don't wanna be a sheep. Bah. crap, crap, crap. How am I in the pool? I don't get it. Car still in there? Yes, it is. Excellent. I still don't know how I crashed into a pole and ended up with a pole. I love how far away you always. Alright, let's try this again. There we go. Let me try this again. Whee! All right.
What can the best mechanic in LS do for you?
You ain't shit.
The cats in the cradle in the silver sea. Little boy blue and the man on the moon. When the time comes and I don't know when. Get together then. No, have a good time then.
Yeah.
And the cat's in the cradle and the silver spoon. I haven't been to my apartment in forever. And the cat's in the cradle and the soul. Alright. Let's move on to something else. Ding, 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 ding.
EA Sports. It's in the game.
It's in the game.
Cebulski, welcome to the world's most famous arena here in Manhattan. The Flames take possession here on the opening draw, and we are underway. Passes right to the front, and they can't convert on the play. Here he is in close, denies him in close. Still plenty of time left in this frame. still looking for our first goal. The Flames take possession off the faceoff. And not much on that one. Nice start winning the draw here inside the offensive zone. He was locked in there. Lindholm's won the draw. Quick pass to Goudreau. Handles it along the blue line. And they fail to go tape to tape. New York's gained possession. Gaining momentum along the wing. Sabinejad's hauled down. Penalty on the way. Time for the official to pass down his sentence.
You react, you go to get the puck, and you stick your stick into the guy's feet. Down you go.
2 minutes off to the box. The frozen biscuits dropped, and we are back underway here.
2 minutes for Trippi.
Carries it across the line. Here's the pass. Whiffs on that, and that's picked off in front. Puck knock loose in the neutral zone. Takes the feed in the middle of the ice. Centering pass. Stones him in front.
He's sharp on that one. Nowhere to go for the puck.
Can't catch up to the pass. He scores!
Pretty bold play to get out and score a shorthanded goal. You've really pushed the other team backwards with this marker. The good thing he one-times this puck. The goalie almost gets there, but the pass is on his tape in the low slot, and he beats him clean.
The Flames have set the tone early in this one, Ray.
You can take control of the pace if you play it from in front. They've done that very well here.
Shorthanded by number 9.
Centering pass. He scores! And a productive season continues to climb.
And he hasn't had many dips at all. What a nice year he's put together. Again, these guys' arms are going to get tired. 2 goals in 10 seconds.
Conversely, deflating for the other team.
Man, that is a kick in the shins right there. They just couldn't stop the bleeding.
On the doorstep, they score! Another short-handed goal!
One is impressive. Multiple is just remarkable in the same game. Man, he laid a beauty of a pass across there. Enough air to clear the sticks, and it lands perfectly on the shooter's stick.
Monahan's won the draw. The Flames played along the wing. Wrist shot from the slot, and he gets a paddle on that one.
But he came out and challenged him. Good save.
Moves right to the middle, and they can't connect. Aaron pass, and the play's broken up. Along the half wall with the puck, and he totally whiffs on that one. Great poke check on the reach. Retrieves the puck, trying to kickstart this power play. From the left side, they enter the attacking zone. Here he is, wrists it on net, gives them nothing in front. Sabinejad's been tripped up, and we got a penalty coming up here. Good heads-up play in the defensive zone. Let's get the official decision. Caught him just as he was picking up speed, and he's going to pay for it with the trip.
Oh, you're spinning with him, you're trying to get your stick into the puck lane, and you end up tripping him up.
Damn it.
Takes the feed, and he comes up with it. And another stop.
Yeah, it's a sharp save, James. Right in the middle of the ice, he makes the stop and pushes it away. Oh, there's going to be a penalty on this play here, James.
He almost lost it for a second there, but regains control of the puck. Breakaway, and the goaltender gets pokes it. There's the whistle, and we've got a penalty shot being called here.
Of course we do.
While he's in the clear, the penalty shot is the right call.
Makes the stop under pressure.
Shooter didn't get done what he wanted to. He wanted to open the goalie up, but the goalie stays square and makes the stop.
The Flames have been all over them, and there's still plenty of time left in this first. Backlund's won a big draw on their own end. Strong defensive effort. The Rangers pick up the puck here in the neutral zone. New York's got a hold of it against the wall. Takes a shot, and he makes the save. Calgary's got possession while undermanned. Couldn't catch up to that pass. New York's got the puck. Panarin's taken down to the ice. We got a penalty coming up. Pokes the puck away. tries to get this man advantage going from their own end now. The Rangers take it across the blue line. Excellent stick work on the play. And there's the whistle. Let's hear the official call. The Flames have been handed a 2-minute penalty for tripping.
Funny, coaches always tell you, get your stick on the puck. And then when you try and the guy trips up, they tell you, get your stick out of there. Kind of stop.
And a nice poke check inside the neutral zone. It's a 3-on-1. And he's signaling penalty shot here on the play.
He broke free. It looks like he's in all alone till he gets tripped up. This is the right call.
Comes up big with the save.
Man, he read the shooter like a children's book. No problem.
Still lots of time left here in this frame. It has been a one-sided affair. 3-0 is where we sit. And now it's over to Tanev. Moves the puck inside the offensive zone. Here he is in front. Scores! And that's the hat trick!
To get it done on the road is a really special accomplishment. You're dealing with checkers. You're dealing with the line matchup. And it doesn't matter where you are. 3 is a great night.
Calgary's up here in the first, and they could easily be up by more based on what they've done offensively.
He's third of the game.
With possession along the wall. And that one's broken up. Shesterkin's going to slow things down and up for the whistle.
Oh, you got to kill the play eventually. That way everyone can get reorganized.
Calgary's been the better team here in this first period, and as a result, they've got a big lead. Puck picked up by Tanev. Can't connect. The Rangers get a hold of the puck in their own end. Smart defensive play there. Quick feed to Howden. Handles the puck from the left side. To his teammate. Not able to connect. The Flames will try to shave a few seconds off this penalty now. Calgary's on the attack. Let's the wrister go. Denies him in front.
Smothered that in close chance.
And that pass goes awry. Sends one over. Snaps one on net. Stopped by the goaltender.
I like the goalie's positioning here. He was aggressive enough to make a save on a dangerous chance.
The centermen glide into position. Calgary's won the draw and they'll go to work. Scores! He does it again!
Every time they look for a goal, he seems to be around it. That's 25 this season.
New York's going to switch things up between the pipes.
He can't get over to the bench quick enough. Now he can get rid of that mask, throw in a ball hat, wrap a towel around his neck, and try and relax. This has been a rotten night for him.
And he can't hang on after that hit. New York's got the puck in their own end. They're looking to make something happen through the neutral zone now. Pokes it away in his own end. Back at the point, they set it up. And now he moves it quickly to Panarin. Snaps it on net. Too much congestion blocks the shot. Under siege, trying to get it out of their zone. All alone! Oh, what a stop by the goaltender.
I thought he was beaten, but he makes a nice stop here.
Big play inside the defensive zone. Slides the puck over. Looking to make something happen along the boards. Great pad save.
Gorgiev's got a pretty difficult task here. He's been sitting over there charting faceoffs on the bench in a ball hat. Now you got to jump in and play goal.
Sabinajad's got the puck in his own zone. Trying to get back on the attack now. Calgary's gained possession along the boards. Quick pass over to Simon. Through the neutral zone now, picking up steam. Redirected shot. Great save by the goaltender to stay with that tip.
Yeah, it's in a dangerous spot. He makes a good save here.
The Flames gain control of the puck against the wall. Down the right side and into the zone. Here he is in front. Goalie makes a save.
No room for the shooter. The goaltender snuffed it out.
Shot tipped in front. Saved by the goaltender who stayed with it on the redirect. And couldn't find the intended receiver on that one. Puck grabbed by Lindholm. Couldn't complete the play. Tosses it on to Tkachuk. The Flames carry it along the wall.
Wow.
Scores! Johnny Gaudreau!
He's able to work his way into the low slot to take that pass. He doesn't stop it, so the goalie can't catch up to it.
Calgary's won the draw. Here they come on the attack. And tries to make a diagonal pass. Scores! His second of the night.
Now, things go well for you if you score multiple times in a game. This has been a terrific night for him.
Calgary's taken full advantage of their scoring opportunities with a comfortable lead here in the first. The Flames win it. Grabs the puck here in the neutral zone. Deflected in front. And that one's broken up. Great block there. And he makes the easy save.
14 minutes, 11 seconds.
Kreider's trying to change a few things up. This pointless streak is starting to nag at him.
Calgary's been the better team here in the late stages of this first period. More shots, more goals. Simple as that. Taken by Valimaki. Swing and a miss. Picked up along the wall by Ryan. And they can't connect. Calgary's got the puck along the boards. Into the corner of the attacking area. Centered out in front. Can't connect. Puck scooped up by DiGiuseppe. Regains possession at center. Looks to set up at the point now. Scooped up along the wall by Ryan. Moves the puck to the attacking area. Pass right on the doorstep, and that's broken up. Sends a pass over, and now it's grabbed by DiGiuseppe. Calgary's got the puck inside the defensive zone. Final minute approaching here in this opening frame. The Flames have been the better team so far in this first period. They've had multiple scoring opportunities, and as a result, have the lead. Bennett's won the draw here in the offensive zone. Turns it away. Takes the puck along the boards. Save made by the goalie.
Sharp reaction save.
Play set to resume with the faceoff ready to go. Play resumes as they win the draw here inside the offensive zone. A chance right in front. Stopped by the goaltender. Box has been brought down, and we're going to get a penalty here. Well, there's the end of the first period of play, and man, what a one-sided affair we've seen thus far.
Looking for a way to show love for your team? Don't forget, Team Hack
Giveaway
Night is right around the corner. The first 3,000 fans in the arena will pick up.
The Rangers will start the period with a full two-minute man advantage here. Right to the middle! Stopped by the goaltender. The Rangers have a hold of it in the defensive zone. Now he takes it over the line.
He's got two goals already. If he can find a way to get a third, he's going to end up with a selection of hats in his stall after the game. I've had those. You look at the hats. Some of them are great. Others look like they've been worn for about 15 years. They're gross.
Calgary's got it in the offensive zone. Move to the middle, and the defenders come up with the puck. New York's got it in their own zone. Gets the full use of his stick on the poke check. Centering pass, can't finish. Oh, Rame, blown opportunity.
It really is. I mean, the play is sitting right there. There's a scoring chance to be had.
Scores! Well, who needs a power play when they're shorthanded like this?
This has been amazing. Woo-hoo. What an effort shorthanded by them as they've capitalized down a man a couple of times tonight.
Calgary set the tone early in this one, and it continues here in the second.
Their first period was good. They built upon it here in the second. They haven't given them anything in their own zone, and they've really had the puck a lot.
Oh, what a missed chance that was.
Yeah, he's got to make a better play there. He's done everything right. Now you just got to get the puck on the table.
54 seconds.
Good defensive stop with the poke check. Here's a shot, and the traffic neutralizes that threat. Trying to come up with a huge defensive play to get this puck out of his own end. The Rangers gain possession in their own end. Here they come, three of them, off a stick. Calgary's got a chance to work the transition game now, shorthanded, and sends it just out of reach. Grabs the puck in the slot, denied by the goaltender. The Rangers move the puck in the defensive zone. New York's coaches will not be liking that power play opportunity as they fail to convert and give up a shorthanded one.
Well, now they got a bigger hole to dig out of. They give up the shorthanded goal, a sloppy power play, and they pay for it.
One-on-one with the goaltender. Denies him with a big-time save.
He thought he had him beat, but the goalie gets over to make a great stop.
The Flames have dominated them thus far and continue to do so here in this second. Calgary's got it in the defensive zone, and he slides it quickly to Tkachuk. The Flames move to the offensive zone, sends it over, scores, and there it is!
20 goals makes you feel like you've had a pretty consistent season. That's a good number for him to achieve. A sweet feed there. The butterfly pass goes across, and the shooter doesn't miss.
The Flames have looked good offensively tonight, generating all sorts of opportunities. Moves around along the half wall. And that one's broken up. Pass across to Hedl. New York's got it against the boards. 8 seconds. Nice poke check. Calgary's got the puck along the wall. Lindholm's going to play it against the half wall. He scores again!
Well, you get one, you think you might get two, but after a while, you're like, hey, how many can I get? The puck keeps coming to him, and he keeps finishing it off.
The Flames are really starting to turn this thing on in a second.
They seem a half a step quicker all over the ice. That adds up into a lead that they can extend.
Puts it to the front of the net, gets a piece of it with the blocker.
Aggressive stop out on top of the crease to make the save on a dangerous chance.
Busted up on the play.
Now you get the right spot.
Off the post and into the back of the net.
Just a quarter of an inch keeps that puck out. If it hits the post more directly, it stays out. As you're a shooter, that's a great sound.
Woo-hoo.
This drives coaches crazy. Everybody's staring at the player behind the net. He's only dangerous if you turn the net around. The dangerous guy's in front of the net. Oh, yeah, he's the guy that scored.
The Flames are on fire tonight here in the second.
Domination right from the very beginning of the game. This is now an absolute landslide for them.
Calgary's got into the offensive zone. Boston Twig.
He puts everything behind this. He's got it right in his wheelhouse. And then the stick just craters on him.
And a poke check knocks the puck away. Stays with it. Moves it to Howden. Just wide of the net.
It doesn't matter how close it is. If it's not on the net, it can't go in.
Unloads a shot. He scores! One-timer and a beaut. Calgary's been dominant tonight as they make their way back to center.
They have scored almost at will, in particular here in this second period.
Sabinajad's one possession. Oh, the officials saw that trip, and the hand is up. Maintains possession, and the puck leaves the offensive zone. They'll be forced to tag up. Here comes the call from the official. Lindholm's called for tripping. He's off to the box.
Reaches in with his stick and gets nabbed for the trip.
New York's got another opportunity here on the man advantage. Bennett's won the draw deep in the defensive zone.
Heck, you want your power play to at least be even for the night. They gave up a shorthanded goal earlier. Here's a chance to redeem that.
He scores! A shorthanded marker!
I don't think the penalty killers ever really look for a shorty, but if the opportunity's there, now they're more aggressive than they've ever been.
The Flames have been lighting the lamp all night, and they continue to do so here.
It doesn't always work like this, but they've had the puck the whole time, and they've scored the whole time. It has been a one-sided affair.
New York's got control of it now from their own end. Howden's got the puck. Oh, smart heads-up play to poke that one away. One-on-one with the goaltender, and makes the save.
Gorgiev's really had a difficult time tonight. He's not looked comfortable. Even in warm-up, I thought he was a little bit shaky. He makes a good save there to keep his team somewhat in the game.
Calgary's offense came to play in a big way, and they lead big time here in the second. Zibanejad's won the faceoff. Through center along the wing. Calgary's going to be able to kill a few seconds off now with the puck. The Flames played along the boards. Blocked!
Oh, he got it away quickly. The puck just doesn't get to the net.
And that shot gets caught in traffic. The Rangers gain control of it. Here they come up along the wing. Strong defensive effort. Calgary's looking to break out. From the right side, they gain the zone. Slides it across. Great reflexes, another save.
Stop one, stop two. The goalie makes a couple of excellent saves. Oh, look at that. Here we go. We got a penalty coming up right here.
There's the whistle. Penalty coming up.
Ooh, shit.
The Flames will lose a man, tripping the call.
His stick gets in between his feet, and when the player goes down, the penalty's going to be called.
New York's power play unit puts their hard hats on as they go back to work.
What a game of cat and mouse. This becomes 5-on-3. Power play's looking for the perfect play. Penalty killers are trying to...
And they score shorthanded!
You go into this penalty trying to keep the game level. Now you get a bonus, that shorthanded goal.
The Flames seem to be turning this into a pad to stat night.
Those are always fun. I mean, if you're on this side of it.
Yes,
if you're on the other side... No fun allowed.
And still lots of time here in this second period. Centered out in front. He scores. Even undermanned, they deliver.
That's a sloppy play by the power play. But shorthanded, they get aggressive. They get up the ice and are able to score while down a man. I thought he was going to go five hole there, but he changed the angle of his blade and went low stick side. Beat the goaltender clean.
Did I?
Calgary's widened the gap yet again tonight, Ray.
How far can you widen a gap? Because they keep adding on to it, it seems like, shift by shift.
Puck picked up by Tanev. The Flames take it along the wall. Oh, he got all of that with the blocker by Georgiev.
High quality chance, high quality save.
Calgary's had the better scoring opportunities and lots of them, which is why they lead in a big way here in the second. Offense's own faceoff and he wins the draw. Easily turned aside by Georgiev. It's in! Another shorthanded goal!
James, I look over at the bench. The coach is kind of giggling a little bit. I mean, who expects to score shorthanded, let alone multiple times in the same game?
Unbelievable!
He makes a great play on the net. He's been doing it all season long. That's why he leads his team in goals.
The Flames continue to apply the pressure, and the offense continues to roll.
This is like a steamroller now. It's like nothing will slow them down.
Faceoff here in the neutral zone, and we are back underway. Center down in front, takes a wrist shot, gets a stick on it to make the save.
Oh, he reads the play really well to get out and aggressive to make that save.
Strome's got it on the offensive end. Good defensive effort to poke it away. Calgary's moving it along the wing. Sends it across. Big stop by the goaltender right in front. The Flames continue to lead in the second. They have been the busier team in the shot department, and as a result, they lead. Calgary's won the faceoff. That goes off the mask.
We used to laugh about this and say, the goalie's got to answer the phone because his ears are going to be ringing. But I'm sure the trainer's going to check on him here as this hits him right in the face.
The centers will glide into the dot. Sabinajad's won it in their own end. Quick feed to Strome. The Flames get a hold of the puck undermanned. Nothing doing on that. The Rangers take possession here in the open ice. Jabs the puck away. Nice zone entry from the middle. Here's the pass.
Whoa.
Scores! That's three!
I have 9 of these, James. It is such a cool thing to score 3. You feel so good about yourself.
The Flames widen the gap yet again here, Ray.
As an offensive player, when these nights happen, you can't get out there fast enough. You think each shift is going to bring you another goal.
Finds nothing but air on that shot. Huge steal in his own end. They've got numbers. Here's a shot. Comes up with a stop. The Flames will kill off a few extra seconds now. New York's power play is over. What a disaster as they give up a shorthanded goal.
I certainly didn't like much about that power play. The shorthanded goal, of course, is the exclamation point.
great defensive play. Looking to set up offensively. Here's a shot. Takes it right in the chest. Moves the puck to Goodrow. Looking to make something happen in the offensive zone. Big save. Taken along the wall by Tkachuk.
Oh, puck doesn't get there. So crowded in front of the goaltender.
And the goaltender grabs that one for a whistle to try to slow things down here. Calgary's up for good reason. They have been the more complete team offensively, which is why they lead late in the second. Grabs it at his own end. Calgary's got a hold of it along the wall. And he denied that opportunity. Nice pass. Simple stop by Georgiev.
Away from harm's way. That's a good save.
New York's got a hold of the puck. Nice poke check inside the attacking zone. Under a minute to go here inside the second period. And he whiffs on it. And that one's broken up by a great defensive play. New York's got it in their own zone. Calgary's got a hold of it against the wall. Stopped by the goaltender.
Well, by being in the right position, James, he gets out tight to the shooter. There's nowhere for the puck to go.
Calgary's got to be happy with where their game is at so far tonight as they continue to lead big here late in the second. Bennett's won the faceoff deep inside the offensive zone. Stopped by the goaltender. And the horn sounds to stop the bleeding, at least for a few minutes anyway.
Every playoff game, our team store brings you our item of the game. Stay warm and stylish here in the rink with a scarf tonight priced at just $10. Make sure to stop off at any team store here at the arena. Pick up your specially priced item.
It's about to go down. Period number three. James Cebulski, Ray Ferraro, ready to bring you the action. It's been a total mismatch here as we get underway for the third. Let's see if anything changes. Once again, I'll send it back down to my broadcast partner, Ray Ferraro, who is at ringside. Ray, we've got two periods played. How do you see this thing?
The Flames don't have to score anymore. This is such a comfortable lead. Just make sure that they protect the puck and play this thing right to the end.
Lindholm's not going to like the call, but the officials see tripping on the play.
Trying to get into position to get to the puck. He takes out the player's feet, and off to the box he'll go.
Along the right side into the offensive zone. And scores!
You get one, you want to think about a second one. It doesn't matter if you're at home or on the road, but you do this on the road, you feel a great accomplishment.
And there's the one hat that he gets for scoring on the road. The Flames have built themselves up a comfortable lead here in this third period. Right in the slot, and a stick in the lane ends that threat. Icing's the call. You know the coaching staff's not going to love that one.
Well, I can think of about three plays he could have made other than that one, but hey, that's the way it goes. Now you need your centerman to win a draw.
Calgary's won the draw.
After the icing, now you've got the puck again. You can wear them down quickly. Oh, that's going to be a penalty. They're going to have to call that.
Levo's been nabbed for tripping.
Trying to get to the puck, he reaches his stick right into the guy's feet, and down he goes.
Bennett's won it off the faceoff. And now he angles it across to Tanev. Along the right wing, they enter the attacking area. And that one's blocked.
Yeah, good positioning, James. He gets up tight to the shooter and snuffs that one.
And that's picked off. Looking to break out here on the power play. Good heads-up play in the defensive zone. Moves it quickly over to Tanev. The Flames move it in. To his teammate, he scores! That's a short-handed marker.
James, they took advantage of one little crease, and they were able to race up the ice, get themselves a short-handed marker here.
Calgary's taken a playbook out of the Ray Ferraro School of Hockey here. Just be aggressive, goal after goal.
Man, when you score, go get another one. You've got the other team down, go get more. Because you make yourself feel...
He scores! Another short-handed marker. You don't see that often.
No, they're not a very passive group killing penalties, are they? That's a couple of times where they've just taken advantage of a mistake and raced up the ice.
Calgary's having a lot of fun out there tonight, but Ray, I can imagine that's a different story on the other side of the bench.
Yeah, half the guys out here are having fun. The other half, this game can't end quick enough.
Right in front of the net! He scores! His hat trick on the night!
What a great night for him. He's had some chances. He's capitalized three times now, and on the road it feels really good. That is a bang-bang play right there, James. That pass is on the tape, and he doesn't stop, and he one-times it into the net.
The Flames haven't missed much tonight, Ray.
No, they'd have to play really poorly to screw up this now. They have played outstanding hockey.
Puck is dropped, and we are back underway.
His third of the game.
On the attack along the boards. He scores! What a counterpunch shorthanded!
Teams are talking more and more about being aggressive when they're down a man. This is the result. Every once in a while, you're going to punch one through shorthanded. That's a great pass. Good hands. That you elevate the puck over the defender's stick and the shooter catch and release. And it's in the net.
The Flames are on absolute cruise control here in the third.
Well, they've built such a large margin, you can use your whole bench and coast it in.
His 10th of the season.
Calgary's got the puck against the boards. And they can't convert on the play! Rocked them in the open ice. Puck grabbed by Tanev. From their own end, trying to kickstart this power play. Play is blown dead. We've got a penalty on the way.
Bullshit.
Monahan's getting called for tripping.
He's fishing around trying to get to the puck. Unfortunately for him, he sweeps out his feet.
The Rangers send their man advantage unit out once more. Puck is dropped and he wins the draw here in the defensive zone.
Well, you can almost feel like you're licking your chops here with a 5-on-3 power play. Attack the net. See if you can get some chances early.
Pokes it away to keep the pressure on. Play whistled dead because of an offside. The Flames are on cruise control here in this third period, leading big. Calgary's got a hold of the puck off the draw. A chance in front. Scores!
Short-handed again. Man, that other team's going to have to lock this down. You cannot be giving up goals on the power play. It's really good work offensively as they grind away till that opening shows up. And that's the one-timer from the low slot.
Calgary's won it. Taken by Anderson. Calgary's got the puck along the wall. And that's stopped by the goaltender. Great save to stay with it.
He's sharp on this one. Out on top of the crease aggressively to make the save.
Moves inside. Stones him in front.
Buffy flares up the arm with the blocker. Makes a pretty good save here.
The Flames have put a lot of pucks on net, and as a result, they lead it early in this third period. Now a quick pass to Levo. Gains the zone from the right side. Sends it over. Wow, another shorthanded marker.
Well, they're not laying back at all. They want to kill the penalty, sure, but they've seen something they can take advantage of. Excellent puck movement on the odd man rush. They catch them short, and they make them pay.
Officials getting ready to drop the puck. Puck possession, so key in today's game. Moving to the middle, they score! And look at the bench!
Well, wakey-wakey over on that power play. You give up multiple shorthanded goals in a game. You gotta know the coach is not gonna be very happy. This is a really good place to get lost on the ice. The defensemen are down low defending. The forwards are worried about the point. If you can find this high slot play, you often are going to get a one-timer.
Calgary's on total cruise control early in this third period. Puck scooped up by Tanev. And that's broken up with a stick in front. Can't connect, and it totally whiffs on it. There's the whistle as things will slow down here for a moment.
Always a good play if you're not sure what's going on. Freeze the puck.
Sabinajad's won a big draw on their own end. There's the whistle. Well, it didn't light, and here we go.
Yeah, James, that shot is so late. The goalie's not expecting it anymore. And when you shoot it like this, you're going to get somebody to bark at you.
Thank you. And down he goes.
That's a clear winner right there.
Damn right.
This has been a rotten night from the get-go for them. I think this fight's a little message to his own team. We can't go away quietly.
And now it's grabbed by Tanev. Centering pass!
Except they lost the fight.
Oh, how did he come up with that stop? Brings the puck into the offensive end now. Excellent stick work on the play. Up along the wall on the right side and into the attacking area. And just out of arm's reach on the play. And that one's broken up. Pokes the puck away. The Flames have possession shorthanded.
That's probably not what they were planning on the power play. They serve up a shorthanded goal with the special teams unit, but now both teams back to even strength.
Oh, they're not going to think too much about that. You want to at least generate a little momentum on your power play. Not only did they not score, they gave up a shorty, which is always deflating.
To the front! And there's the save. Calgary's showing no signs of slowing down here in this third period, up big time. Puck is dropped and we are back underway.
Of course I'm not.
Backlund's got it along the boards. Here's a chance. Slides it across. He scores! That's 30 on the year!
Now you're getting into the big numbers. You get a 30 and beyond. That's a great year. Man, the goalie's going to look at his teammates and say, is anybody going to cover the high slot? He was so open, he was able to hammer home the one-timer.
Puck picked up by Anderson. Centered out in front, and they can't connect. Picked up along the boards by Hanifin, and that's broken up. At center ice now, he grabs the puck. Pokes it away in his own end. They've got the defense outnumbered. Sends it across. Can't connect. Handles the pass from the right side. Knocks the puck away in the open ice. Pushes it across to Tkachuk. Calgary's got it along the wall. He scores! He can't miss tonight!
Unbelievable to get this many chances, but to be able to put them all away. Shooter's able to corral that saucer pass, and then he beats the goaltender.
Calgary's goal-scoring abilities have been on full display so far this evening and here in the third.
Really impressive display. They've moved the puck well, skated, really forechecked. Well, there's really nothing they haven't done tonight.
Nowhere for that shot to go through. Denies him again.
Quick reflexes. You make one, damn. You make two stops before the puck is cleared away.
The Panthers are on the save-the-date calendar next for these guys.
Yeah, fans of both teams will really look forward to that matchup. It's generally a pretty aggressive game.
Never an off night in this league.
Oh, there's going to be a penalty on this play here, James.
There's the whistle, and a penalty is coming up on this one.
It's okay.
The Flames are being called for tripping.
Now reaches in with his stick, and he'll go to the box.
Elias Lindholm.
Calgary's got it along the wall. Here's the pass.
Wow.
Scores! Not the special teams unit we expected to deliver.
No, this is a real turning point in the game here as the shorthanded group capitalizes, gets on the board.
The Flames could almost put this one in neutral here for the rest of this third period.
They've dominated much of this game, and the score is clearly reflective of that.
Puck is dropped and play resumes. Tanev's got it along the wing. And that one's turned away. Nice stick work to knock the puck loose. Giordano swooping in on the attack. Finds some space in the corner. Quick shot! Gives them nothing in front.
Oh, he had to get up tight to the puck. In close, he takes away any room.
Angles it over to Kreider. And he's taken down the official's arm, signaling for a penalty. And there's the whistle stopping the play.
In a shifty little play, you're trying to get to the puck, you get your stick in the wrong spot, he steps on your stick, and there's nothing you can do.
And now it's to Anderson. Gains the zone from the right. Puts it up front! From the slot, wrist shot, scores! Is that 50 now in the year?
Yeah, good math there, James. I thought when you got your shoes off to count that we were in trouble, but you got it right.
Always nitpicking my math. Not bad year, though. Calgary's all smiles on the bench next to you, aren't they?
Yeah, they're having lots of fun. Not so much on the other side, where this night has been a nightmare.
Monahan's won the draw. Calgary's got the puck against the half wall. And they can convert on the play. And they can connect. Grabbed along the boards by Anderson. Can't find his man. New York's got the puck along the boards. Smart defensive play here in the open ice. Offside the call, and we'll have a face-off just outside the blue line. Calgary's laying a pounding on the opposition tonight, generating numerous scoring chances and converting on what feels like almost all of them. Centering pass! Nice save by the goaltender to get a pad on that. Pokes it away here in the neutral zone. Slides the puck down low. Can't get a hold of that pass. Picked up along the wall by Bennett. Couldn't complete the play. Referee's got his hand extended. He caught that trip right in front of him. There's the whistle. Let's get the official decision. Tripping the call on the play.
I don't necessarily think he's trying to trip him here, James, but he gets his stick into his feet. Down he goes.
Calgary's won the faceoff deep in their own end. And now he passes it to Anderson. Here they come on the attack. To his teammate. And that skips away on a nice defensive deflection. Streaking into the attacking zone for the right. Good defensive stop with the poke check. Takes a hit, he goes down to the ice and coughs up the puck. Sabinejad's tripped up and the official's hand is in the air, signaling penalty. His reflexes on display tonight. Here's the official call. Well, the official's going to give him 2 minutes to think about that one.
Yeah, you can argue for a few seconds, James, I guess, but you already know at this point you're going to sit down.
The Rangers once again send out their power play unit.
Not often you get a 5-on-3 of this length. You can score early. You might be able to get two.
Sends it over. Scores! Well, who needs a power play when they're shorthanded like this?
This has been amazing. What an effort shorthanded by them as they've capitalized. Down a man a couple of times tonight. The good thing he one times this puck. The goalie almost gets there, but the pass is on his tape in the low slot. And he beats them clean.
Calgary's been the better team tonight. They have turned good defense into solid offense, and they lead here in the third. Tanev's got it in the offensive zone. Can't connect! The Flames get a hold of the puck along the boards. Tanev's going to play it to the corner. Move to the middle! New York's got the puck inside the defensive zone. Trying to get something going here with this man advantage as they start from their own end. There's the whistle stopping the play. Penalty coming up. I don't think this will have much of an impact on this one. Bennett's off to the box. 2 minutes for tripping. Played with fire. He got burned, Ray.
He's digging around for the puck, and sometimes you just get caught. This time the player goes down, and he's got to go to the box.
Here's a chance right in the slot. Oh, and he'll be shaking his head on that as they were so close. Receives the pass. Puck knocked loose in the neutral zone. With the stop. The Flames wanted to focus on putting more pucks on net going into tonight's game. They have done just that and then some here in the third. Tries to get this man advantage going from their own end now. Pokes it away to stay on the attack. New York's gained possession along the boards. Drives to the paint. He scores!
Son of a bitch!
Look at the relief on his face already. He hasn't even played many games, but you want this as early as you can.
So close to achieving my first shutout.
The Rangers have a long way to go still here in the third.
I guess you get your scorers out there and you try and keep climbing out of a hole, but it's not very pretty right now.
Moves the puck along the half wall. Great save by the goaltender on that redirect. Scooped up along the wall by Hanifin. And a strong effort on that play. Calgary's not far from the finish line here as they lead it late in this third. Monahan's won the draw. Tanev's got it against the boards. Denies him in front.
Nice move by the goalie to get out close to the shooter. Oh, look at that. Here we go. We got a penalty coming up right here.
And the goaltender gets to the bench for the extra attacker. Penalty coming up here. A little too late. I'm sure some people in this building would have wished the clock would have just run out. We got a minor penalty coming up here.
For sure,
on this one.
James. I mean, this call was going to be made. You could see the play develop, and now they're going to have to serve 2 minutes.
Takes a shot. The Rangers take possession in the defensive end. Grabs the puck and moves on out here with this man advantage. Strong defensive effort. Quick pass across to Anderson. Moving into the attacking zone. Here's a shot. Comes up with a stop. Taken along the wall by Hanifin. The Rangers have the puck now. Into the attacking area from the left side. There's the whistle. Penalty shot to call.
Tripped up on the breakaway.
How?
The ref makes the right call.
There was no breakaway.
For a penalty shot.
How is that a breakaway?
One-on-one with the goalie. And he scores on the penalty shot.
This is actually a pretty difficult beat. Going to the forehand every time.
That's bullshit.
He goes over to his forehand side, and he has to get it past the goaltender. It's a good move.
Backlund's won the draw here in the open ice. The Flames looking against the half wall. Scores! Another shorty!
Oh, they do it again. Their power play has been terrible, and this shorthanded group has taken advantage of them all game long.
The Flames have been enjoying Pad the Stat Night here. It's been going all night long here, even in the third.
They came to play tonight. They have not let their opponent breathe, and it has been a dominating performance.
Along the half wall with the puck. Let's it go! Gets in front of it. The Rangers will play it in their own end. Pucks the puck away. The Rangers have it against the wall. Snaps it onto the net, and he gets in the lane to block that. Driving right to the front. Turned that one aside.
Somehow the shooter got loose in the slot, but the goaltender's equal to the task. That's a good save.
Scores!
Two goals in 50 seconds. So quickly on the board.
This is where you want run time here in hockey, right?
This game can't end quick enough. They're getting pounded.
The Flames have not stopped the firepower display tonight. You impressed down there?
It's like they're going downhill the whole game. Their opponent hasn't been able to keep up at any level tonight.
He scores!
Well, there's 24, James. That's a good milestone to step across. That pass is on and off his stick in an instant. No stopping it, one timing it so it's in the net.
Bennett's won it. Puck grab by Anderson. The Rangers' man advantage comes to an end and not the result they were looking for, giving up a shorty.
They're not going to be too thrilled when they get a look at the film on that power play. Ineffective and, maybe more importantly, they give up the shorthanded goal.
And the final seconds ticking away here in regulation. And that's blocked away. He almost lost it for a second there, but regains control of the puck. The Flames gain possession along the wall. Move to the middle. Whiffs on that. He scores. That's the hat trick.
Now, what a great feeling to get three goals in a game. Doing it on the road is a real nice trick.
Calgary's on fire tonight, and they show no signs slowing down in the third.
This has been almost a perfect hockey game for them. When they look at the video, they're going to be really happy.
Here's a short pass to Tkachuk.
No, I'm not, because I had a shutout.
Right,
the closest I've ever had to an actual shutout, and it went out the fucking window.
Works it across to Panarin. And a great heads-up defensive play here. Played big in the moment there.
Panarin's point streak has been a thing to behold. You start to get superstitious on a run. You do everything the same. You wear the same suit all the time.
Taken by Valimaki. Stopped with ease. The Flames are going to want to bring this big lead home late in the third. Monahan's won the draw here in the offensive zone. Couldn't make that one happen. From the left side, they enter the offensive zone. Nice poke check. And he regains control of the puck. Lets it fly and makes the save. And that's all she wrote from this one tonight. Lindholm's team gets the win, and a big part of that, his hat trick performance.
He's so good when he gets the puck on his stick. He's got a real sense of when to deliver it, and he was lights out tonight.
In the meantime and in between time, he's Ray, I'm James. Good night.
Should've had more. Should've been a shot out. Scored the same amount of goals in the third period than I did in the first two together combined. I'm gonna say I'm gonna play one more game, but I'm actually not. I'm gonna have to wrap up because I just remembered, because it's coming up on midnight, and I actually got to record a video tonight before I go to bed. I've got an unboxing video to do, so I gotta shoot that before I go to bed. If I don't, it's not gonna get done for a while, and I gotta start getting some videos uploaded. So yeah, I'm gonna call it a night. Excuse me. We'll play some more hockey. Maybe on Saturday. I'm off on Saturday, surprisingly. So I got to work tomorrow again. I'm off on Saturday. Schedule's like all messed up. I don't even have a schedule for next week yet. I have no idea who's. I have no staff right now. It's hilarious. It's just me and a manager from another store who's been helping consistently, but she still has to take care of some stuff at her own store, which is closed right now. So I only get her about 4 days a week, which is fine, but I need at least one more regular person, and apparently nobody's available to be a regular person. I don't know why they just won't bring back one of my staff members instead of keeping them laid off right now. It doesn't make sense, but whatever. We'll see what happens. Anyways, so yeah, I'm gonna go. I gotta go shoot that video. Then I gotta hit the sack, because, yeah, work tomorrow. So, yeah. Alright, boys and girls. Good night. And I will catch you on the flippity flip flip flop. Whatever that means. Good night, guys.